नमस्ते टू ऑल. टुडे वी विल लर्न मोर अबाउट द स्क्वायर रूट. टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू नंबर्स एंड फ्रैक्शनल नंबर. दीज आर द टू टॉपिक. वन इज द स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द टू नंबर्स एंड देन द फ्रैक्शन. सेकंड इज अ फ्रैक्शनल नंबर. द फर्स्ट वन सेज स्क्वायर रूट. दिस इज स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ प्रोडक्ट. दिस इज अ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू नंबर. Let one number be A, let one number be other number be B is equal to under root A multiplied by under root B. What we read as a product of square root of product of two number is equal to the product of square root of numbers. Now, let us take example. For example, if we have a number 25 and another number is 144. Question is given that we have to find the square root of this product, that is 25 multiplied by 144. Please remember, do not multiply. If you multiply, the number will become a bigger one. Then it will be difficult for you to find the square root, whether you find by long division or prime factorization. First thing, this is equal to under root multiplied by under root B. So this will be under root 25 multiplied by under root 144. Now find the square root of root 25. If this number is small, you remember, so the 25 is a square of 5, or 5 is a square root of 25 multiplied by square root of 144 is 12. So answer will be 60. You do not have to multiply. That's why this formula is given: under root of A multiplied by B is equal to root A multiplied by root B. So write them separate and write down the square root of them, and then that's the answer. Now, second is the fractional number. In second case, the numbers are, they are in the fraction, that is numerator upon the denominator. For example, under root of A by under root of B is equal to under root A upon under root B. As we have done in power, and we have done in exponent and power, that was 2 by 5 whole raised power 2. We can write it as a 2 raised power 2 or upon 5 raised power 2. So similarly, this is a square root of A upon B is, it can be written as a square root of A upon square root of B. Again, you may take any number in place of A. So let us take 225, and downside we can take a small number 16, or you may take bigger number, depends upon. Let us take 169. So we can write it as a 225 upon root 225 upon root 169. Now this will be, what is the square root of 225? That is 15, and the square root of 169 is 13. So that is the answer. Now the next example is, let us take number in decimal form. This is 25.6 multiplied by 52.9. This complete is in square root. So how to do this type of question? We have done that root A multiplied by B, product of A multiplied by B under square root is equal to product of A multiplied by product of B, and other this is square root of A upon B is equal to square root of A upon square root of B. So first of all, what we do, we remove the decimal. If we remove the decimal, there is one digit, we can write 10. In this one case also, we can remove the decimal and we can write 10. So this number has become of the form, it's 256 multiplied by 529. 10 multiplied by 10 will become 100. So next is, we can write it in the form of 256 multiplied by 256 multiplied by 529 whole upon square root of 100. Now we divide this. Here we have applied this one, that's root a. This is the complete root a upon root b is equal to root a upon root b. Now further separate them, that will be 256 multiplied by 529 upon square root of 100. Now find the square root of 256, 529 separately and 100. Those who have learned till 30, they remember square root of 256 is, that is 16, multiply by square root of 529 is 23 and square root of 100 is 10. Now next is we multiply this one, 3 is a 48, 8, 4 carry, 16, 2 is a 32 and 4, 36 by 10. So the complete answer will be, this answer will become 36.8. And that answer is going to divide by 10 and this will become 36.8.